Tonight, we're gonna do the lunar base mission and Bring Down the Sky DLC. And then we're gonna try to sweep out any other little systems that we can while we're there. Might head back to the Citadel if we have some time. I don't know. I don't know if I'll have time. Just get right to it. Alright, so... Oh yes, we were right here. We were gonna do the Worthington. So, since we're here, let's just do it. It's a pretty good tech team. I'm not sure what I'm going to fight, but we'll go into it blind. We'll figure it out in a minute. Oh yeah, okay. This one isn't that hard. We should be able to handle this. No problemo. I mean, save it just the same, but... it's just the crew and the crazy girlfriend.
Looks like this vessel was abandoned.
Most of the systems seem to be disabled. Only basic life support appears to be functioning.
I've got to go through my equipment and see if there's any better gear. There we go. It's a much better sniper rifle. Yeah, give me that one. Yes, give me that. And... yes. And yes. As much as I love the pink armor, I think it's time to upgrade. See what we got here. Camo armor. Could dig it. Smash damage, yes. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Is an upgrade for you. Shield wise and tech protection, yes. And it's pink. Liaran pink, yes, please. How about Tally? Anything that Tally can wear? Nah. She's got her own shit suit. That's why we gotta do Bring Down the Sky, because you get a nice suit for the Quarian. Better cooldown. You know what? Yeah, let's do that. And yes, better shotgun. Sure, why not? For Liara, I think we get the best pistol we could possibly have on there. Alright. Not that we're having a big firefight here, but...
What was that? Is there someone else on this ship?
Yes.
Somebody set that trap. The whole place could be wired.
I mean, in there is where you want to go. There's some stuff up here, too.
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. Give her a chance to... Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
What? Nice that we start off with an easy one.
They say Jacob's gone. They say his brain isn't functioning anymore. And they want to shut off his machines. But Jacob's the only thing in the world that matters to me. I don't know how to help him, but it's tearing me up inside. I just feel so helpless, so damn angry. Dr. Smith gave me some meds to calm down, but I didn't take them. I can't. Not until I figure out a way to help Jacob. I won't give up on him. I won't.
This one was like a nice, you know, moral dilemma. Guy's a vegetable, but he's still technically alive. What do you really do?
Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die with dignity. That's what he would want. I'm more worried about Julia now. She's showing signs of severe depression. I gave her some meds that should help, but I better warn the captain.
And here she comes.
I will destroy you!
Well, you know. I don't think so, my dear. You shouldn't sneak up on people with guns.
All targets eliminated.
Looks like that machine is keeping him alive.
I do not see any brain activity on the readouts. He is dead. This body is just an empty shell.
So you get the moral dilemma to turn off the machine, let him be.
No point leaving him there like a vegetable.
It is your decision, Shepard. But perhaps we should wait until we have more information before we do anything. That was the compassionate thing to do, Shepard.
You say so. I mean... probably was. Guy's a vegetable. Do you want to sit on a... out in space on a dead ship, just floating away? You can't move, you can't feel. I don't think I would want to be that way. But who knows? Who knows what it's actually like? Alright, so that was the quick little cleanup of that system. We are all done with Gemini Cygna. Let us go to Lunar Base, the Sol System. All these planets so familiar. So this is an interesting mission because of what happens later in the trilogy, but as far as action-packed or anything, nah, not really. It's kind of boring, actually. Not necessarily boring as it is tedious. Might bring Rex for this one. Because I don't think there's anything on Luna to mine, because obviously it's Luna. We've been mining it for years. Why would there be anything out there? There might be some things to check out if we wanted to, though. Basically some turrets that we could destroy if we wanted to for some XP. That's about it. There's some salvage, but I don't think I didn't bring Tally, so electronics is not going to be that high. Oh no, our electronics is maxed out, so we could go get that. Alright, we'll do that then. Yeah, okay. So that's where we have to go. And then all the other ones are unmarked areas where we can just shoot some turrets. Let's do it! Yeah, let's go out that way first. It's right there. Very primitive driving. If you turn that, then you turn the whole thing. Some XP. And there we go. Where's Earth? There's the sun. There's Earth. It's a nice view. Alright. Next up is all the way out here. There's a bunch of turrets we can shoot. You gotta go up the hill to get to them. So I guess we'll just start making our way up here. We're gonna have to go up eventually. Two hits. Yeah, that's where we're supposed to go. There's another set of turrets down here, though. So let's go find that. Here they are. I love this dumb vehicle. Whoa. Here come the rockets. The dumbest rockets in the world to fire exactly where you were. Oh, and that one actually hit me though. What I get for calling them dumb. Taking damage. Oh, what are you driving, dude? Got that taken care of. Yeah, just at the top of the hill there. So that was about. I didn't even see. I didn't even see how much XP we got for that. I don't know, like a couple thousand. It adds up. I don't even really monitor how much XP we have. Like, how much do I have? Like, what level am I? 22? Yeah. We're doing fine. We're doing fine on XP. Whoa. Now comes the tedious part. All three of these similar bases, they get a little harder each time you go. You missed. Again, how do you miss? There you go. That's what I was looking for. Getting 323 every time for these? No, then it is worth it. Oh, not every time. 165 every time. Alright, so it doesn't matter which order you do these, because it gives you the same thing every time. Whatever the first one is, you're going to get a specific room. So, like, if I went in here, or if I went in there, or if I went in over there, it doesn't matter. You're going to get the same room every time. I don't know why they did it that way, but they did. Alright, so let's first save. Well, let's first level up, and then we'll save. Alright, what do we want to level? Guess I should start putting some points into that so that I can get my armor up. All right, so we're starting this mission at 11:10. And I consider this the beginning of the mission. Ah, damn it. I need a tally. I mean, it doesn't matter. It's just XP. But still annoying nonetheless. Alright, you guys wait here.
Shields.
Sure did. None of the other ones are moving though.
I've lost shields.
These ones you don't have to worry about too much. They are what they are. Pretty straightforward assault models. It's the rocket drones that you gotta be careful of, because they can one-shot you. Where the hell are you guys? They get so stupid in this. Come on, drones, bring it on. I see you there. Couple more in this one. First one's not really that difficult, it's just, again, tedious. And as I say that, we almost get got. That's why it's always best just to funnel them down here. One left. Now the really tedious part, shooting these stupid power junction things. You gotta do it in every single one of them. So tedious. Alright, let's see. Toxic gas is being vented into the air. Asshole VI. Only taking 2 shots. It gets more annoying in the other rooms because they start dropping shields everywhere. It's like the game creators were like, we need to make this harder, but we don't feel like making anything more to it. We just want to use what's already here, basically. Data access point. Huh. Must not have ever noticed that before. Some free XP. The lamps on the optical mainframes flicker and die. The first of 3 computing clusters containing the VI is offline. So essentially,
I'm a little busy here.
Why this is so interesting is because this VI is actually the beginnings of an AI. And that AI is our lovely friend Edie. Before she even becomes fully aware of her existence, she becomes aware as, you know, Shepard's coming through killing her. Meh. That's why we needed to bring Tally. Missing out on the XP. I don't know if it would make me start the whole thing over if I went back up to the ship now. It might. It's not worth it for, like, maybe 100 XP. Not even. I don't even think it's that much. To decrypt a thing. Alright, ah, damn it. I can't save. Damn it. There we go. Now I can save. I always want to save in these places, because it really only takes one cheap shot, and you're dead. Shut up. Shut up like a mofo. Fall back. Fall back, please. Poor Liara. I Come on, guys. Fall back. There you are, fall back. Unless you're stuck in a wall. Are you stuck in a wall? Because I have seen that happen before, too. Yeah, I know we are. And you're standing in the middle of the room. I thought taking two biotics would be a smart move. Definitely should have brought Tally. But we're almost done. This is one where they throw up shields, I think. Which are mildly annoying. Barriers sure are holding up the room. Down. One more to go. The other nice thing about the lunar mission is that you get an extra perk. What the fuck? One more to go. Bang this out. Then we'll go do an asteroid. How about that? Asteroids are fun. Now this is the one that's going to have rockets, so definitely need to save here. In fact, do I have better equipment at all? Probably not, but worth a shot looking. Nope. Best sniper rifle we can go with for now. Yeah, that's right. Back here, my dear. Yeah, watch out for that one. That one's a dick. That's what I'm talking about. That is what happens. They just come at you stupidly fast. That's why I always save there. Cause no thank you. Alright. Do I have like any armor for Rex better than what I have? I have Krogan armor. You just can't wear it. I got all these amps too. Jesus Christ. Here, have an amp, bro. Have a damn amp. Why would I not use an amp? Should be spamming all their shit. Anyway, let's see if they had a better shotgun than what Rex had. Nope. Nope. He's got the best one he can have for right now. Nothing we can do about that. I need you guys to maybe, like, post up here. I'll run in, stir up the hornet's nest. What I need from you is a warp.
I've lost shields.
Shield down.
Watch out for rocket guys. Gonna get crazy. Yeah, I didn't have the heal back fast enough. Man, they just come at you like a pack of fucking rats. I don't remember them coming this fast at you though. Damn straight kill them all. Post you guys up that you can actually do something. Be back here. I hate that the first one you can't like individually assign where to put them. It's just both of them blindly following an area.
Thank you.
rocket guy. On me, Rex. On me. Is this on veteran? It's not even on hard. Or hardcore, as it's called. Or insanity. This usually happens, though. This is the one that's always like, you're going through, you're doing the first two, and you're just like, okay, it's not so bad. And then you come to this one, and you're just like, what the fucking hell, man?
All clear.
Alrighty. Here or something, I don't know. Can't get this damn shot off. Might need to go back up to the ship. What do we got equipment-wise? Oh, here's a decent one. Now you get the best shotgun. That might help. Those tungsten rounds. Let's try that shit. Told you this mission wasn't gonna be easy. They still don't come. We're just gonna cheat. Fuck those guys. Just gonna bank on them not being able to open doors. additional security drones powering up. Take them down myself, basically. Plan. You guys stay here and distract them. I'm gonna go run in. Actually, I got an even better plan. Can't open doors. To go assault rifle on this because I don't have a good enough sniper rifle to do this. Give me back the gun, Liara. Here, you can have this one. We got two tungsten rounds. I'm gonna give them. Give one to Rex. Or Liara, rather. This is not working. I don't understand why I can't aim with a friggin' assault rifle. That didn't work at all. We did less. No, I think my plan is going to be what I did before, where I basically just cheat.
Finally, some action.
Okay, Rex, at least hold the shotgun. Lear, at least hold the fucking assault rifle.
Clear.
Cover.
You two stand back here. Shoot them as they come down. That wasn't happening.
Not now, Shepard.
Lure them all the way in, and I'm gonna just run right by them.
I can't make it.
The terrain is too rough.
The terrain is too rough. Didn't lure him in enough. Oh, come on! Now I'm just getting angry. Thank you. Alright. Pretty much on my own for this. There's only three of them. Let's get rid of that one. These things are so super effective, we should use them against the Reapers. With me. Sorry, Lear. You can get in here, that'd be great, but if not, ain't gonna worry about you. Okay. You both use to cover this door here. This way. Just don't stand there. Don't stand there either. You're just going to get shot. Okay. Well, I guess that was the hard part. Can't remember if I'm gonna have to fight my way out of here or not, or if it just lets me end this mission. Sanity anymore either. Did it once, never doing it again. Finally! A burst of white noise over. A burst of white noise over all frequencies nearly deafens you. Your hard suit's heads up display interprets it into a series of zeros and ones. They repeat again and again, blanketing all frequencies, until the lights on the final VI cluster flicker and die. Operative or medic? So either increase your first aid or spam your overload and sabotage. Spam your overload and sabotage. That's exactly what I want to do. Alright, so. Are all those assholes still alive? They are not. Now, I've definitely killed those guys before, I guess because I usually wait for Lunar Base until after I've done all the other side stuff, so I'm probably at a higher level. More health, more shields, easier to take these things on. But that was ridiculous. I've never had it be that much of a pain in the ass before. We started at 1110, doing just these debunkers. It's now 1157. So that was long and annoying.